Hi, and thank you for following this technical presentation series on renewable energy studies. In this video, we will discuss the full converter wind turbine control. Full converter wind turbines, which I will call FC wind turbines in this presentation, use a permanent magnet synchronous generator and an AC-DC-AC converter system, which consists of two voltage source converters, the machine side converter or stator side converter, and the grid side converter. A DC resistive shopper is used for the DC bus overvoltage protection. Although not shown in this figure, a line inductor called shock filter and an AC harmonic filter are used at the grid side converter to improve power quality. This slide is from a previous video. As a reminder, the wind park controllers in the park receive their control references from the power plant controller, also called PPC. In the case of the EMTP 4.1 generic model, only the park reactive power control loop of the PPC is modeled. To control the reactive power, the PPC sends a voltage deviation reference to all the turbine controllers. By default, the controllers control the voltage at 1 per unit. If the PPC commands more reactive power, it sends a positive voltage deviation reference, and the converters end up producing more reactive power. Here is the control and protection diagram of the FC wind turbine in EMTP. The sample signals, which are the voltage and current on each side of the converter, are put in per unit and filtered. The input measuring filters are low-pass type. The compute variables block compute the variables used by the FC control and protection system. In these blocks, you will find PLLs, which are algorithms which determines the voltage angle and frequency and help to achieve the transformation from the ABC domain to the DQ0 domain, which is used for control purpose. The pitch control block limits the mechanical power extracted from the wind by increasing the pitch angle when the wind speed is above its rated. The protection system block contains cut-in and cut-off speed relays, low voltage and overvoltage relays, machine side converter and grid side converter overcurrent protections, and DC resistive chopper control. The LVRT and OVRT functions are in this block. We will discuss this block in more details in another video. The EMTP 4.1 generic model is controlled using vector control techniques in the DQ0 domain. This control type is the most commonly used by wind turbine manufacturers in the industry. Some of its big advantages are that it allows decoupled control of real and reactive powers, which mean that the real power is controlled only by either the D axis on the grid side or by the Q axis on the machine side and vice versa for the reactive power. Another advantage of this control type is that when the system is balanced, the D and Q axis currents and voltage are constant in steady state. They are therefore easier to control than sinusoidal quantities. On the machine side, the DQ transformation angle follows the permanent magnet machine flux. The Q component corresponds to the real power, and the D component to the reactive power. Therefore, by controlling the Q axis current, the converter controls the machine electromagnetic torque. The D axis current is controlled to zero, as there is no need for reactive power on the machine side. A two-level control loop is used for the Q axis. The reference of this loop is the machine electromagnetic torque. This reference is provided by the maximum power point tracking, or MPPT, and is set to get the maximum power out of the wind. It uses the blade rotation speed and some optimization curves to find the optimal electromagnetic torque available. This device will be discussed in detail in another video. The torque is transformed in a Q-axis current reference using the permanent magnet constant flux and a coefficient which depends on the blade aerodynamic, which is hard-coded in the version available in EMTP 4.1, and which has been determined in collaboration with wind turbine manufacturers. More information will be provided in another video. The inner loops control the converter voltage to follow the references of the outer loops. Their gains, which are the same for D and Q axes, are calculated as shown here. They are using the machine parameters and follow the internal model control method. In the generic model mask, user can set the rise time, which determines the inner loop speed. It is typically set to 20 milliseconds. So far, we have explained that the inner loops provide the D and Q axis voltage references. However, the voltage equations of the machines in the TQ domain are written here. To ensure good tracking, the cross terms here must be compensated, and so the final DQ voltage references are the one here. The inverse Park transformation is then used to go from DQ domain back to ABC domain and control each phase of the controller. On the grid side, the DQ0 transformation angle follows the voltage here, right after the choke RL filter at the converter transformer terminal. Since the voltage is 90 degrees ahead of the flux, the D component corresponds to the real power and the Q component corresponds to the reactive power. Here again, two-level control loops are utilized. On the D axis, the outer loop regulates the DC bus to its nominal value. The output of this loop is the D axis current reference, which will be the reference of the inner loop. The inner loop, which is the fastest one, produces the D-axis voltage reference to follow the current reference. Before being used by the inner loop, the current reference is limited by the IDQ limiter block, so the converter does not exceed its current capability, which could cause hardware damage. The limiter function will be explained later in this presentation. The gains of the outer loop PI controller for the D-axis are calculated based on the DC bus capacitance. The equations used are explained here. The Q-axis loop now controls the Q-axis voltage in order to follow the reference sent by the PPC for the Park reactive power control. The outer loop produces a Q-axis current reference, which is also limited and sent to the inner loop, which command the Q voltage reference. The outer loop here is a proportional controller where the gain is set by user in the mask. For the grid side converter, the gains of the inner loops depend on the total impedance seen by the converter. The transfer function is shown here, where R and L are the resistances and inductances of choke filter, the converter transformer, the Park transformer, and the grid Thevenin equivalent. In the generic model mask, user can set the rise time, which determines the inner loop speed. It is typically set to 10 milliseconds. The voltage control is at the converter terminal, but the voltage measured is after the choke filter. Therefore, and similarly as the machine side converter, a feed-forward compensation is done before putting the converter voltage reference back to the ABC domain. To summarize, the outer loop maintains the DC voltage of the DC bus. For example, if the wind increases, the machine side converter will inject more current into the DC bus in order to get more real power from the wind. This additional injection will tend to increase the DC bus voltage. However, the D-axis control loop of the grid side converter will maintain the DC voltage to its nominal value by increasing the grid D-axis current, which corresponds to the real power. In the end, the additional power from the wind increase goes through the two converters straight to the grid. Let's now explain the limiter device of the grid side converter. During normal operation, the controller gives priority to the D-axis current, which corresponds to the active power. The wind turbines are equipped with a FRT function to fulfill the grid code requirement regarding voltage support. The FRT function is activated when the voltage deviation is above a user-defined threshold and is deactivated when the deviation goes back below a reset threshold. When the FRT function is active, the grid-side controller gives priority to the reactive power current. Here is the user interface of the full converter mask. On the left side, you can set up the parameters related to the machine-side converter, the PWM frequency, the sampling rate, the measurement filter parameters, and the rise time for the inner loop. On the right side, you have the grid side converter parameters, the PWM frequency, the speed for the DC outer loop control, the external system equivalent, which is the Thevenin impedance of the transmission grid the park is connected to, and which is used to determine the PI controller gain of the inner loop. We explained that in a previous slide. The sampling rate, the type of control, this will be discussed in another video. The filtered measurement parameters, the V-loop gain, as explained in a previous slide, and the full write-through characteristics. Let's now go to the EMTP software. To demonstrate the content of this video, let's use the example available in the Renewable Energy Toolbox EPRI Benchmark FSC. What we will do as a demonstration is a step change in wind value. We will observe the different current references in the converter and the DC voltage. Let's first exclude this fault, which is here by default, and go inside the wind park. The structure of the wind park has been explained in the first video of this series. The wind seen by the turbine is here. We can modify it using the control library. First, we unlock the circuit, and what we are going to do is add a step. For the step, we will use a signal generator. The magnitude of the step will be 2 meters per second. The width will be infinite, the bias will be zero, and we'll apply the step after 1 second of simulation. Let's now take a look at the different quantities. First, the DC voltage. So we can go inside the converter, and we see that the DC voltage is available here. Let's put a scope. In the machine side converter here, let's have a look at the Q reference. On the grid side converter, let's take a look at the D reference. The total park power will be visible through this meter PQM1. Before starting the simulation, let's set up the initial wind speed. Right now, the wind speed is at 11.24, which is the nominal value. Let's set it up to 8 meters per second. We start by running the load flow. Here, we can see the initial power from the wind park, which has been modified when we modified the initial wind speed. Let's now run the time domain simulation and visualize the wind step. Visualize the result, let's use scope view. On the first scope, we will look at the DC voltage. On the second one, we'll look at the D and Q axis references. And finally, the park total power. What we can see on those graphs is, after the initialization period, we reach a steady state. After 1 second, the wind increases, and so the DC voltage increases slightly, and then goes back to steady state. If we take a look at the D reference in red, it is in steady state, and after 1 second, it evolves with the wind. Finally, if we take a look at the real power in red and zoom a little bit, we see that the power is constant, and after 1 second, it starts increasing with the wind. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you found the content useful. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to write them in the comment section or to send us an email at info@emtp.com. For more information, please visit our website. Thanks and have a good day. Bye.